in achieving positive parenting, intentionality is a must. Welcome to Parenting Essentials for this week. This is the home of key strategies to parenting. Once again, you are welcome. My name is Oye, Oyelayo, your parenting coach. Today I'll be talking about intentionality. And I have a question that I threw you on my Facebook account over the week. I'll be reading the question and I'll be reading the few answers I got from some of our parents out there. So let's enjoy the moment together. One of the reasons I found out in parents who are not intentional is not having the clear vision of how parenting will be. A lot of people fell in love. It's okay, all good and perfect. Some grew in love. Okay. But what are the picture you have after these things? You got married, congratulations. But did you think about having children in the context of getting married? A lot of people fell in love with a beautiful lady, fell in love with a handsome looking guy. That's all that they had in their head. They're not thinking about children. But this came along, ends the unintentionality. Trials by errors. Let's take one day at a time. It's okay. They treat their children anyhow. They were not psychologically prepared for being a parent. And these are the major errors we have out there in parenting. Parenting must be purposeful. It must be intentional. You have to know what you're going to. You have to be prepared psychologically. Don't forget, I do often say this, that your mental health is a must to achieve greatness in your positive parenting. Mental health, having the vision, you have to be able to see ahead. What sort of kids do I want to raise? What are your kids? What are your goals? What do you want to achieve? What are the mistakes that you made in the past that you would like to correct in your growing glory? Hence, the intentionality. The question I asked over the week on Facebook was, what is that one thing that you are intentional about in parenting? Yes, you. I want you to take a moment and just answer the question right away. If you have not seen this post on my Facebook page, I want you to take a moment and think about things that you are intentional about in your parenting. Most especially, one thing that you are intentional about in your parenting. Once you're sure about this one thing, take a moment and just drop it in the comment section. And I'll be glad to read your comment. I'm just gonna start from myself. Oyelayo, yes. What is that thing, one thing that I am intentional about in my parenting? I have quite a number of things that I am intentional in my parenting. However, there is one and most important thing for me in my parenting is my children having a personal relationship with God, establishing their spiritual life, knowing who they are in Christ Jesus. This is the most important thing to me, because when I think about every other thing, it is attached to this one point that I'm so particular and intentional about. I want a child who is confident, who knows who she is or who he is. I want my child to know that he or she is unique. Amidst other things that I'm intentional about, I believe if my children can know who they are in Christ, if they have a personal relationship with God, every other aspect of their life will be settled, like their academics. Because the Bible will tell them that they can do all things through Christ that strengthens them. Like building their confidence, like knowing who they are, like having the best behavior, being confident out there, being able to say no in the midst of trials and tribulations, temptations, confrontations. I believe the Bible is the word of God. I believe them having a personal relationship with God, not because mommy is a believer or daddy is a believer, but because they know that they are children of God. They have to be able to know that I am a child of God, not because my parents are children of God. And this is going to help them in every other aspect of their life. I strongly believe this. academically, they will know what and who they are and what they are supposed to achieve, because the Bible is complete. The Word of God is complete. I don't know what you believe in, but I'm telling you my own aspect as a believer of Christ Jesus. I will just go ahead and read the question again and read few answers that I got from some of our parents. Before I go ahead with that, if you are an intending parent, planning to get married, or you've been married now, you want to build a family, you want to start raising a family, ask yourself, what are the things that you are intentional about in the journey you are about to enter? What are the things, what is the vision that you have? Note it. If you cannot answer this question to yourself, then you are not ready. Be ready psychologically. Prepare. Get ready. Don't be like somebody who doesn't know how to swim that just jump into the sea or the ocean. What is going to happen? Someone who is ready to be a parent and doesn't know what it entails, or doesn't know his vision or his intentionality in parenting, is like somebody who's jumping or diving into the sea without knowing how to swim. What is that one thing that you are intentional about in parenting? I've said my own. I believe you know yours now. So drop your comment at the comment section. Miss Oya will be so glad to read your comment. Please always drop comment. We appreciate your comment. It means a lot to us. The first comment I have here is from Oluwatoyin Oyekan. And she says she's more particular about their self-awareness. Wow. In spirituality, esteem, confidence, and giftings. I believe this can drive other areas as they grow. Good morning, sis. Thank you, sis. And I believe this is a very good point, just like similar to my point. You know, she's so particular about their awareness in spirituality. Spirituality, esteem, confidence, gifting. Wow, I really love these things. And she so much believes that it's going to drive every other area as they grow. I have more comments, and this one is from Glory Nora Pascal. Glory Nora Pascal said, one thing that I am intentional about in parenting is raising a confident and godly child. Wow, that's really great. Raising a confident and godly child who stands for the truth, even in the midst of storm. We know what the world has turned to today. How many people are standing for the truth? We talk about corruption everywhere in the world out there today. This thing starts from the home, and it starts from as early as possible when you overlook things. Your little one is already telling lies, but you find it funny, laughing around about it. That's not good. Hey, come on, stop that. Let them know the truth as early as possible. Allow your children to grow into the truth and stand for the truth. Thank you so much, Glory, for this. Can you boldly say that your child can stand for the truth in the midst of storm? Those of you that have grown-up children, young adults, can you beat your chest and say, my child can stand for the truth in the midst of storm? Let's go ahead and see more comments that we have from these questions. This one is from Amadu Oyekola Deborah Opeolua. She says, wow, yes, good and godly morals. Good and godly morals. Godly parenting for future leaders. Good upbringing that will raise and bring up good and godly heroes for our future generation to know Christ, stand, to know Christ, stand firm and be great. Also to have passion and zeal for the kingdom of God. So help me God. Amen. I claim that also. You know, these are really, really important points. Wow, this is so amazing. I'm very always happy to see parents who are intentional in their parenting. It gives me joy. It brings so much joy into my heart. Because this is a journey we have to go through together. If our parenting can be intentional, the world will be a better place. The world is collapsing right in front of our eyes. What is this? What is the standard of the future generation? For the future generation to be great, you have to do your work as a parent. I, Oyelayo, I have to do my work as a parent so that the world, the next generation, will be happy and will be able to be proud of them. The next comment is from Bukola Adedoyin, and she says, It is meant for raising children and bringing them to their normal position in life and Christ-like. Wow. Everything is talking about pointing to spirituality. And I'm so glad, like, we have like-minded moms. The next comment is from Oluwafunmilayo Adedayo Otusoya Oyedele. She says, raising godly offspring and making them understand that they are unique in their making. No intimidation of any kind. Wow, I really love that. I'm always glad when I know that parents understand that every child is unique in their own way. No intimidation. You are king, I'm a queen. You are unique, I am unique. This is what you are good at doing. This is what I'm good at doing. So that is bringing me back to this very point that said sometimes back, concentrate on your child's strength, not what your child can't do. They are unique in their making. Wow, that's fantastic. No intimidation of any kind. That's really very, very nice. So I'll go to the next comment from Mommy Pat Olurotimi. She says, being a role model to them spiritually, like modeling what you want to see. You're telling your child or your children to be spiritual, read your Bible, pray, but they'll never for once see you read your Bible or see you pray. You have to model what you want to see. Being a role model to them spiritually, socially, in the choice of friends they have, having godly communication, being orderly in all they do, and knowing that hard work is a virtue. A child of God must have and live in the word you know and read. So it also means that parents cannot say, do what I say and know what I do. If you want a positive, growing glory, amazing children, you cannot afford to say, don't do that. Don't do that for me. What you're doing? Don't copy me. Just do what I explain to you. Children are mirrors. They mirror what they see in our lives. We have to model whatever we want to see in the life of our children, both spiritually, socially, every aspect of their life. It is much easier when you model, when you show them, let your actions speak louder than your voice. Parenting is much easier in that way. Thank you so much, Mami Pat, for that point. And the last comment I have today is from Gertrude Inyakam. Gertrude says, raising champions with Christ as their model. Wow, this is really fantastic. Raising champions with Christ as their model. Which better way to raise champions in our children than showing them that Christ is their model? I just want to say thank you to every mom who dropped comments on these questions. I appreciate some didn't drop comment, but they like and reacted. And I really appreciate their reactions, their like, their thumbs up. And I really want to say thank you for all these positive-minded people, minded mommies, like-minded mommies. Almost everyone pointed at the spiritual aspect of their children's life, making Christ at the center of it all. We modeling what we want to see in the life of our children. So we can all together learn about our intentionality. We can improve on our parenting. I've learned so much about this comment, and I believe every other person who is going to be seeing this video is going to learn one or two points from the comment and from the other ones we are going to be getting later. Don't forget, parenting must be purposeful. Parenting must be intentional. I am Oyelayo Oye, and I'll say bye for now. I'll see you in my next video.